do something, Bigby, before he completely tears up the place. Whoa, 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 hey, hey!
You've got something on your face.
Fuck are you talking about, you stupid cunt?
You're not as bad as everyone says you are.
Please, Bigby. Promise me you won't tell Beast you saw me.
I promise.
Thank you for trusting me.
Have you seen my wife? Have you seen Beauty?
I'm staying out of it.
Out of what?
Come with me.
No. Don't interrupt me, Miss Snow!
You asked me a question.
Don't change the subject. You are to blame for this unpleasantness, Miss Snow.
No, I'm Dee. He's dumb.
You're gonna tell me right now what...
Dad!
I'm looking for the woodsman.
Well, he's not here.
Ollie, you're out of paper towels and, they're gonna string me up, Bigby. Like you said, it looks fucking bad. It looks really bad, but I didn't do it.
All right, I got $100 for the first bloke that can tell me something about a girl named... Fuck, man!
This fucking lab dog. He comes sniffing around this part of town. Rich fucks in the woods need a shakedown. Ain't that right, Bigby?
Now things are worse off than they've ever been.
Well, that's not true.
Right. We've had it worse, but not by much.
You're making this more difficult than it has to be. If you just cooperate and answer the questions, you can go home. Maybe get some sleep. How are you feeling? I know it's been a long night for you. You look like you could use some rest.
I'll be better when I find who did this, which I can't do while sitting in here.
We all want the same thing here, Bigby. Look. I know what you must be going through. Really, I do. But I could use your cooperation. That's very helpful. Thank you. I'm Detective Brannigan.
Yeah. I know. I just said that. Is there something?
Do you hear that?
No.
Please. Please.
I'm sorry. Just make it stop. Please.
We have to go, now.
What did you do to her?
She'll be fine. It's just a memory wipe spell. Very expensive, but it works. The whole station will forget the last 24 hours. and everything they saw at the Woodlands.
Well, hurry up.
Thanks for the lift.
Certainly. We found Tweedledee chained up to a post. That was your doing, correct?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know why you detained him. Dee was at the trip trap when Snow was left at the Woodlands, so he couldn't possibly be involved in this mayhem. Bluebeard's currently interrogating him, and he hasn't said anything useful. And, Bigby, we have to tread carefully here. We can't implicate an innocent man, and people are already worried about your conduct.
He's working for somebody, and whoever it is wants him snooping around every crime scene I've looked at.
That doesn't necessarily mean they're involved in the murders. I know what you're thinking, Bigby. It's been one full night and a slice of morning, and I already miss her too. You know, I never get more homesick than when one of us dies, and now, for it to be Snow, I've never been good with these sorts of things. I just can't believe this is really happening. Our stories used to be so simple. We had a beginning, a middle, and an end. But ever since we moved to this awful city, everything's gotten so confused. Did she, give any indication to what she was thinking? When you saw her last, I mean. I don't know why, but I'd like to know that she was... I guess fine, I suppose.
She just told me to be careful.
She was always fond of you, Bigby.
Yeah.
I don't know what else to say, Bigby. We have to put an end to this. It's been two murders in as many days. If we don't unearth our culprit, and soon, there will likely be another on our doorstep tonight.
I'll get it done.
Please, Bigby, for Miss White.
I got it.
That's not a very good answer, is it?
Come on. Just tell me what I want to know. It will make things a lot less painful for you, in theory.
Oh, were you planning on using that? I just thought you really liked rubbing your little sword.
Fuck! What the hell do you think you're doing?
Hello, Ichabod. Sheriff.
Bluebeard.
I was just chatting with our new friend.
You were supposed to wait for us to get back. I told you, if you want to be involved, you will do things my way. No violence!
Whatever you say, Ichabod.
Hello, Bigby.
I want answers, Dee.
Oh, goody. I thought you wanted questions, and I was having so much trouble thinking of any good ones. Though I'd settled on, how's your head?
You see what I've been dealing with? What are you going to do about this, Bigby?
Shh. Please, try to be serious, Dee. Snow White is dead.
Look, I didn't kill anyone.
And I'm supposed to just believe you.
You were with me when it happened, dummy.
I still have questions for you, Dee.
Sounds like a personal problem.
This is ridiculous.
Let him work.
He's got more experience with these kinds of things.
You know I saw you at Faith's apartment. What were you doing there?
Girl's got air conditioning. You can't imagine what it's like living in a little shithole with no air. Especially with this heat wave going on. Have to find some place to cool off.
All right, Dee. Let's get to know each other.
You know, I really like spending time with you, Bigby. You're so pleasant. Let's be What is it now, Bigby?
Look, I know it's unpleasant. You don't want to be here, right? I'm not trying to make things difficult for you. I just need you to cooperate. Once you've answered my questions, I'll let you go.
It would help if I wasn't strapped to a chair. Fair enough.
Just tell me what you were doing at Faith's apartment.
Look, Bigby, we're not on opposite sides here. My brother and I are trying to get to the bottom of things, same as you.
Your brother? Where was he last night?
I can't say. He could have been anywhere.
Take your best guess.
He didn't do it, if that's what you're thinking.
Then where is he?
No, I'm not sending you after my brother. Look, I answered your question. Can I get my stuff back now?
What did you find on him?
Oh, nothing of consequence, really.
He's being too nice to him.
It's a smart strategy. Be patient.
I'm saving that.
This is really... What's the point of this?
Here.
Yeah, all right. Wanna see a trick?
Look, Bigby. This isn't going to work. Don't you want to find out what happened to those girls? To Snow White?
Let me handle this. So where's your brother?
Look, mate, I'd like to help. I would, but I can't tell you where he is. Last time I saw him, we split up and I went to find Faith. I don't know where he is now, but he didn't kill anybody. Just leave him out of this.
You were looking for Faith?
Look, I went to her apartment. That's no secret. You saw me.
No, there's more to it. You said you were trying to find something.
All right, Dee, since you never answered my first question, what did you want from Faith?
Sorry, I can't help you. I'm not saying any more about it.
You always carry this much cash?
I've got a lot of laundry to do this week. What's it to you? I better get that back.
Come on, Dee. What did you want from Faith? Sweet girl like her.
Sweet? You think that girl was sweet? She was a fucking thief. Fucking sweet.
What did she steal?
I don't know. Just some dumb thing my boss was after.
Your boss?
So let's talk about your boss, then.
You're gonna get me in trouble, Bigby. I can't answer any more of your questions. Any more?
You just carry this around?
Always handy that way.
I'm not sure this is really working.
What the fuck? Bigby, you shit! Oh, you're done playing nice now. Is that it?
Last chance, Steve. Who are you working for?
Fuck you! You're a piece of shit, Bigby. Beauty was right about you. You're just a sick...
Beauty? You're full of shit.
Oh, we're good friends.
That's enough. I will not tolerate this savagery. You think someone was trying to kill Snow? Isn't it more likely someone was trying to get back at you by killing her? It's your violent behavior and inability to control your nature that caused this mess.
Fuck you! Don't put this on me!
What's going on down here? What the hell was going on down there, Bigby? Abusing a prisoner like that. I thought you could control yourself.
I thought you were dead, Snow.
And that makes it okay? I hope it was worth your time.
Okay, you're gonna have to explain this, because I'm really not getting it yet.
After our conversation in the taxi last night, I got a call from Toad. He said his son found a body. We thought it was Faith at the time. Getting her back here wasn't easy, but hopefully we'll find something on her to help us track down the killer.
I should have been there, Snow.
I tried calling the business office, but there was no answer. I couldn't find you, or anyone. So I took care of it.
Snow?
What is it?
I'm glad you're not dead.
Me too. I just want to get to the bottom of this. I just feel like...
What is it?
I feel... responsible, in a way. She looked just like me. And maybe that's why she was killed.
If someone wants you dead, at some point they'll realize they missed their target.
And they'll come looking for me. We just have to find out who did this. And why she was glamored to look like me. I mean, that's what it is, right? So... what's our next move?
Maybe you should lie low for a while? Until we figure out what's going on.
And what? Sit around the business office twiddling my thumbs, waiting for the big bad wolf to solve all my problems?
It's too dangerous out there.
Too dangerous? Bigby, I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore!
I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once.
I'm not yours to lose. I'm sorry. I know it's dangerous, but I'm not helpless. I can take care of myself. I've been doing it for centuries. TJ is waiting inside. He was so freaked out last night, he wouldn't tell us much. Even now, he just stops talking altogether after a certain point. He's pretty shaken up, though, so try not to be too... you know. TJ's over there. I don't know if you want to talk to him first or after, but let me know when you're ready to see the body. I want to be there. Bufkin, do you have a second?
Of course, Miss Snow.
Snow's perfume. And acids. Maybe this has been harder on him than I thought.
That's enough. Mira, vanish! Cancel!
What the hell are you doing?
Don't even get started with me, Sheriff!
What's going on?
I saw what you did down there. Is that how you treat your prisoners? I'd be lying if I said I didn't want to give Tweedledee a good smack after what he put me through. But what you did to him was way over the bloody line. You scared the shit out of me, little boy. He saw everything!
Okay, Mr. Toad.
No! I want an explanation.
And what did you expect to see?
I thought maybe I'd catch you on the shitter. But I saw something worse, didn't I?
That's enough! Mr. Toad, I deeply regret the distress this has caused you and your son. But right now, we need to carry on with the investigation. I will be happy to speak with you about your concerns later, but you must understand how urgent this is. We need to talk to TJ.
This ain't over, Big B.
TJ. It's all right. Are you ready to talk to Mr. Wolf?
Watch yourself, Big B. You do anything to hurt me, boy.
It's okay.
This won't take long.
Go ahead, TJ.
I go swimming at night sometimes, in the river. I wasn't doing anything bad, I promise.
Of course you weren't.
We know you're a good kid, TJ.
Just tell me what you saw.
I was there, under the big blocks, and I heard noisy feet. And when I hear that, I'm supposed to go underwater and stay real still and quiet.
That's right, son.
Then I saw... I saw the lady!
It's okay, son.
Take your time.
The lady... fell in, but she didn't have her head on. I thought she was gonna pull me down too. Cause she had rocks on her feet and she kept falling down in the dark parts.
Cinder blocks tied to her ankles. Is there more, TJ?
Is it true? You know when people are lying? I heard you could do that. That's why you're the sheriff.
Yeah, part of my job is being able to tell when people are lying. I'm really good at it. Is there something else you want to say?
Please, don't be mad.
What is it, TJ?
I didn't stay under the water.
What?
I know I'm supposed to, but I was scared, and I went to the top again. I couldn't help it!
I gave you very specific rules. You have to stay quiet and out of sight or bad things can happen. I told you!
You're not in trouble.
Look, Ellie's not.
Not this time, Toad.
So you didn't stay underwater?
I don't know if anyone saw me, but someone said, stop laughing. And then I was scared, and I went under for as long as I could.
Wait, you heard someone?
Yes.
Why didn't you tell us before?
I didn't want to be in trouble.
Were those the same words they used? Stop laughing? Try to remember exactly what they said.
They said, stop laughing at me.
Did you hear anyone laughing?
No.
Sheriff?
Did you see who it was?
No!
Bigby, he's frightened.
Okay, TJ.
I'm sorry. After I came up again, there was no one there. And I ran home, that's all. I promise! I want to go home.
Okay, you can go.
Thank you, TJ.
Okay, son. Let's get you home.
You did a good job, kid.
Come on, then.
That went about as well as I expected. You want to go look at the body now?
Yeah.
Come on.
Oh my goodness! I almost forgot.
I didn't realize I've never seen her face before now. The glamour is so effective, it's invasive. But just do what you need to do. Check her mouth. There might be a ribbon in there, like before. Anything?
Nothing.
Can you close her mouth? Thanks. That's weird. I don't wear a brooch like that.
Maybe it really belonged to her. Not part of the glamour.
Looks like something from the homelands. Bufkin, do you recognize these symbols?
No, nothing I've seen before.
It looks just like Faith's did.
But there was nothing in her mouth this time. Do you think it was done by the same person?
Hard to tell. Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
No. He said he wanted to run more tests.
Track marks.
She used Mundy drugs?
Looks that way. Pretty heavily, too. I hear they only go for the legs if they've used up the veins in their arms, or if they're trying to hide the marks.
Wait. If the glamour is supposed to make her look like me, shouldn't it be concealing things like track marks? That brooch, too. Why would it change everything else? I've never seen one this sloppy.
It might be a cheap one. Just to get the job done.
The witches upstairs know what they're doing. That's why they cost so much. Unless someone is making glamours illegally?
It's not technically illegal, miss. It's not encouraged, for sure, but there aren't any laws specifically forbidding it.
So there's some sort of black market for glamours?
One would assume so. I imagine anyone with access to the proper books and training could theoretically produce a glamour.
Yet another thing to worry about. Black market or not, it's a pretty good match. Look at that. The buttons aren't exact either. There's an extra one here.
You're right. These buttons are wrong. I wonder...
What?
Snow, do you mind if I, open her coat?
Bigby, just let me do it.
You still okay?
Well, I certainly hope you're behaving yourself up here, now that you're done smashing bottles on people. What have you found out? Well?
Her glamour is defective.
Defective?
We're thinking it's black market. We should really be regulating this kind of thing.
Yes.
We should... keep going.
Are you wearing silk lingerie, Snow?
Why do you want to know?
I'm just trying to see if the clothes are exact.
They're not.
What is that?
It's your perfume.
How do you know what perfume I wear?
You can't fool this nose. Also, I saw the bottle on your desk. Looks like someone picked it out for her.
So, someone gave her instructions. I've seen things like this before. It's definitely magic. The witches don't usually craft objects these days.
I don't think it's wise to fool around with that. It's some kind of black market magic. Who knows what it could do? We should have it looked at. Just to make sure it isn't dangerous.
You may be right. One way to find out.
What?
There's something in here.
How do we open it?
I think I can figure it out. Something to do with these rings here.
A deer. What does that mean? Oh. Is that...
It's your hair.
Someone must have taken this from my apartment. I noticed it was missing, but I didn't think. This was the last picture I had of Rose and me. My sister and I don't talk much anymore. Who did this, Bigby?
She's a troll?
You gotta be kidding me.
Yeah, she's a troll. Can we move on?
Who is she? That wasn't there before. Who do you think she is? I don't know many trolls, I'm afraid.
Should have left them all back in the homelands.
Maybe Holly knows.
The owner of the Trip Trap? No, she looks a little... Oh, no.
What is it?
It's not Holly. It's her sister, Lily. She was reported missing, but I guess it just slipped through the cracks.
We have to go tell Holly.
Right. Who knows? She might know something about this. Who Lily was seeing.
Well, certainly another troll.
We should go.
You can't go out there.
Why not?
It's too dangerous. Someone tried to kill you. Bigby, you can't let her go out there with you. You'd be putting her life at risk.
Bigby is not in charge of me.
He's in charge of this investigation.
Snow wants to come with me. I'm not gonna stop her.
But...
We should leave now. You ready?
Yeah.
This whole thing is complete bullshit, and always has been. I mean, what's his job, really?
To keep shit from reaching the woodlands. Jack, I don't know where they are.
You're a bar. You're supposed to have darts around.
And I normally do, but who knows where the fuck they went to after...
Come on, Holly. I need entertainment. This'll do.
Holly, you got a minute?
Why?
Please, Holly. It's important.
Miss White! I heard you had kind of a strange morning.
It's been kind of a strange morning for everyone, I think.
Every time I see this guy, he seems to lose weight. It's amazing. It really is. He loses weight and yet somehow keeps all the muscle.
Jack.
Wolfie, my dear, how are you? Because, you know, we were just talking about you. All of us. At the bar, here.
I just need to talk to Holly. Privately.
All right, just give us a second first. I'm dying to hear about the body that came out of the East River this morning. It was a fable, right? Oh, everyone knows.
Tweedledee was just here.
He said it looked like Snow White.
What the hell, Crane?
Sorry.
Tweedledee said you arrested him for no earthly reason. Kept him locked in the cellar all fucking night. He said you tortured him. Which... I don't know, that seems like a breach of your legislative duties. Bigby, come on. You can't be so dumb as
Jack,
to-
Jack, find the off button, now!
What is it with you two? You and Gran are all, let's get a posse together when there's no one around. But as soon as the big bad wolf walks in, your tails go between your legs. He fucking maimed you. Aren't you pissed? Cat got your nerve? What happened?
What happened? I'm tired is what happened.
Tired of what?
Of trouble, Jack. I'm sick and tired of trouble. I don't want any more. So just stop revving his motor, or wait outside, or fuck the hell off. I don't care which.
Holly.
What?
Bigby, look. Two fables are dead. And shit, Gren's sister...
Holly's sister.
Holly's sister has been missing for what? A few days now? And we haven't heard word one about it from anyone.
Actually, have there been any updates? On my sister.
I don't know how to say this to you, Holly. The woman we found in the river.
Who was it?
You know who it was.
Boy, I sure walked into that one.
If you say one more fucking thing, just one more thing, God fucking damn it! Of course, the dear princess, Snow fucking White, is all safe and sound. Where were you when we reported this weeks ago, huh? Where are you when we ever fucking need you? If you'd give 1 ounce of a shit about her, about any of us, she might have been saved. She might have been cared for. She might have been...
I have to ask Holly some questions.
Christ, give her 5 minutes.
Holly.
Get the fuck out of my bar.
I just want
to... It should have been you. It should have been you, and it wasn't.
We recovered this from her personal effects. I thought you might like to have it.
I didn't know she still had this. The copper was from a dwarf mine. It's very rare and very old.
That was decent of you.
Gren.
Yeah?
Take off for a bit, would you?
Are you sure?
I don't know that much about her life. Honestly, we didn't talk often. She was lost here, in the city. She just got swept away by it.
Did she have any friends? Anyone who could tell us what she might have been doing? Why she'd be a target?
I don't know about her friends. She hung around where she worked, mostly. She was hooking to pay down debt. It ate me up to see her that way. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the Puddin' and Pie. The owner, Georgie, with all his fucking fees, it's a crock of shit. That's how they kept her under their thumb, really.
Holly, it's okay. If it's too much, we don't have to do this.
Georgie. What do you know about him?
We can just go talk to him. We've got a lead. Maybe we can take it from here.
Lily.
Anything else you can tell us?
I don't think so. Like I said, we didn't talk much.
That's all right. You've been more than helpful.
Is she... Where is she?
She's at the business office. She's taken care of.
I'm gonna have to go down there and get her. Fuck.
Please, we can handle the funeral arrangements.
No. It's a formality with trolls. We burn our dead by sunrise or... I don't know. Some old world shit will fuck your soul up.
Of course.
Okay. Good.
Let's go down to the business office and start making the necessary preparations, all right? That club?
I'll go down there now. See what I can find out from the owner.
You were good with her. I'm impressed. Really, thanks. It just made everything easier.
Sheriff, what a nice surprise. I'm not sure I've seen you here before. You're always welcome, of course. Is it business or pleasure?
I've got some questions for Georgie.
Straight to business this time, then. You're in luck. He's here. Come on. I should warn you that Georgie does not like to be bothered when he's working. And he's in kind of a mood right now. I mean, more so than usual.
I don't much care how he feels about it.
Ah, well, you two will get along just swimmingly. Welcome to the Pudding and Pie, where we cater to the diverse tastes of the Fable community. Your pleasure is our pleasure. Your desires are our desires.
Did you know Lily? She worked here?
My lips are sealed. You'd better ask Georgie.
What do you think you're doing? You look like you're trying to take a shit. Who's gonna want that? No one's gonna want that.
I can take it from here.
Good luck.
It's your face. You have to smile. You never smile. How many times do I have to say it? You're supposed to turn the clients on. That's your job. You want them to feel...
Oh, it's you.
We're closed. Keep dancing, you. I didn't say stop. For fuck's sake. You, stay right there. Don't even think about sitting down. We're not finished.
You, Georgie.
Brilliant deduction, Sheriff.
What do you want, then? You here for a little taste? Tell you what, come back after midnight, maybe. I can hook you up. Or, knowing you, she's probably not quite your style. You'd prefer someone who can take a bit of a beating. Tell me, do you prefer a stationary target, or one that will put up a fight? I can arrange whatever you like, for the right price.
I'm not here for that.
Oh, I'm not here for that! You just stopped in for the chips, then?
Jesus, Bigby, you're so corny.
I love it, though.
No, seriously, I love it.
Okay, all right, Sheriff. Just fucking with you.
Look, I know why you're here.
Are you sure?
Listen, Sheriff. Around here, we can't afford to wait for you and your swanky pals to take an interest. We have to look out for each other. When shit happens, I hear about it, especially if it concerns my livelihood.
In that case, I assume you knew Lily was glamoured.
Of course she was, you daft git. She was a troll.
No, I mean glamoured to look like another fable.
Yeah? Well, so what?
Who gives a toss? People get up to all kinds of things when nobody's watching.
You know, it's illegal to impersonate another fable.
It's frowned on.
It's illegal as long as I don't like it. The 13th floor would never provide a glamour like that. It's strictly black market stuff.
Ooh, black market, is it? How exciting.
This is exactly what I would expect from a thug like you. Storm in, throw around a bunch of accusations, try to scare people. But you've got fuck all to back it up.
And we're all just meant to jump any time the wolf shows his teeth. It used to be something, you know.
Nothing to back it up? Well, what the fuck is this, then?
Get that out of my face.
I found it on Lily's body, and it's definitely a back alley job. Where did she get it?
You've got this all wrong. If Lily was doing a special glamour, it wasn't for me. For fuck's sake, I want that kind of heat.
Who was she doing it for, then?
She had clients, Bigby. Maybe one of them was into it. A lot of fucked up people in Fable Town.
Like who?
Try looking in the mirror. Anyway, now to do with me. Go on then. You're gonna hit me? Go ahead. That's what you wanna do, right? That's what you came here for, right?
One more time. Who hired her?
Oh no, fuck! You! Take your sad fucking face where I can't see it! Bloody bastard fucking shit! You proud of yourself, mate? Proud of your little mess? Fuck's sake. Fuck up, Hans.
Hold on a minute. Hans, is it?
Hans just cleans up and provides a little muscle when we need it. He's not gonna know anything about the girls and their clients or any of that. No one knows. Don't you get it? It's by design. Discretion is our guarantee, right? And the way we guarantee that is that no one knows anything they don't have to know, including me. I cover my eyes and take my cut. End of story.
Why not look it up?
What's that?
Isn't there a little book with all the stuff about the girls and all that written in
it? You're a fucking moron!
Show me.
There is no book. And as for you, Hans, we need to work on your communication skills and have a fairly good idea where to start.
Hey, that's my personal property. Sure, go ahead. Do what comes naturally. Unbelievable prick! Hey now!
Cut the crap, Georgie. I want the book Hans is talking about.
Hans is confused. Again. Don't even think about it.
Look, Georgie, why don't you just tell me where the book is?
Can we please not go round and round about this? There's no book. End of story. Do not touch that. You hear me? That's nothing to do with you.
Well, well, what's this? Looks like a floor safe.
I wouldn't know. It was here when we moved in. I don't have a key to it. Sheriff, will you come on? Fuck's sake, I've got to open up in a few hours.
Give it to me.
You're a big bad bastard. We get it. Everyone's guilty. We fucking get it. Jesus, you're killing me. I'm begging you. I'll pay you.
Two women are dead.
Then quit being a bloody idiot. Come on, mate. Leave it. There's nothing there for you.
You might want to stand back.
All right. Bloody come on, then! Fucking trash my business over this bullshit! Protector of Fable Town, my ass. What a load of crap. Once again, don't get your hopes up. There's nothing in here that'll tell you anything. But it's a kick to the balls for me and my club, so he can be happy about that.
Here, this is Lily's last entry. So tell me, Georgie, who's this Mr. Smith?
Oh dear. I'm afraid it might be a fake name, Bigby. Secrecy is sort of how this all works. Even Hans knows that.
What's 207? Room number?
I don't fucking know. Millimeters, maybe?
Don't bullshit me, Georgie. This is your book, your girls.
I'm not their fucking secretary. I give them a stage, I give them music, I provide an erotic venue to attract and retain clients. But let's be clear on something. The girls make the arrangements with their clients, not me. The girls. They're the ones with the Mr. Smiths and Joneses and Mr. X types. Whatever happens outside the club, that's on them. I log the business, take my cut, and I'm out. Now, I've had quite enough of you and your bullying. Excuse me while I call your superiors to make a complaint. Hello? Business office?
Lipstick, lip gloss, compact, glitter. Faith, thanks for covering for me tonight. Let's talk before you go over to the apartment. Lily. Looks like they both saw one of Lily's clients. Lock's been busted open. Broken open, but there isn't even a lock. Faith. Excuse me.
I heard you out there. I don't remember ever seeing you here before.
I didn't have a reason to come here before.
Yeah. You're trying to place me. They used to call me the Little Mermaid. Once upon a time. Does that help?
What do they call you now?
Whatever makes them happy. My name is Nerissa.
Well, Nerissa, I've got some questions.
Of course you do. I don't have answers. You'll have to find those yourself.
Does the number 207 mean anything to you? I assumed it was a room number, but where?
We can't talk about work.
This is a murder case.
I mean can't. These lips are sealed. Discretion is our guarantee. It's how things work here. By design.
People keep using those phrases. What does it mean? This is what I need to know about. Lily's last entry. Who's Mr. Smith? Where's room 207? I have to know.
These lips. Sheriff Wolf, would you like to make an appointment with me?
What exactly are you suggesting?
We could make all the usual arrangements, the usual place.
Okay. What would I need to do?
I need 150. It's not good to be short.
Okay. Oh, I don't...
Wait here for a second.
Not 207?
You'll think of something.
The open arms. This is where they met.
Enjoy your stay. I hope you find what you're looking for.
If the rooms are anything like the lobby, they should cut their rates.
Want it by the hour or for the whole night?
You.
I work here, okay? I work the front desk. It's to help pay rent. So, now you know.
I know I should have told somebody, but Beast would lose his mind if you knew.
Beast is a proud man, Bigby. He wants to do right by me, and he just couldn't handle it if he knew I had to do this so we don't get evicted.
Beauty, I could honestly not care less about this. Do what you want.
All right, jeez. I thought since you didn't tell Beast you saw me, you cared how I felt. But I guess not. So, what are you doing here? Oh, you have a key.
Someone else was murdered last night.
I heard.
The victim was someone who worked at the Pudding and Pie. Lily. She, come around here ever?
Oh, yes. The troll. I did see her. I mean, you know, we never really spoke, but she came off a tad intimidating.
Ever see Lily with someone here? Maybe on a job?
Sometimes, but nobody I've recognized. I haven't worked here that long, though.
How about a room register? Or someone named Mr. Smith?
That's all we get here. Smiths, Jones, or Johnsons. I think the last ones are jokes.
Thanks.
Wait. It'll be better if anyone sees you, that they at least see you with me, so they know that I didn't let you just wander around by yourself. 5 minutes, please.
We'll see, Beauty.
Just be ready to act like I'm trying to kick you out.
That won't be hard.
Listen, Bigby. I assume you'll be filing some kind of an official report or something. Which is fine, it's just that I was wondering if I need to be in it. Do you have to mention my name? I mean, it's not like Beast would ever see your report. It's just, well, you never know.
It's not much of a report if I start picking and choosing which facts to include.
I see. Well, here we are. Which one was it?
You have keys to these rooms?
I thought you had a key.
Not to this one.
Hold on, Bigby. I can't just let you go into any room you want. I mean, what if someone's in there?
I'm investigating a murder. I've got to check out all the angles. You never know what might be significant.
Well, I guess. See anything?
Nope. /207. Open this one.
Well, that's weird. This key is supposed to open every room in the building, but it's not working.
Beauty!
Ah, shit.
Beast?
Bigby? How could you do this to me?
No, sweetie, no. Wait a minute.
How could you do this? We've been together through everything. I took care of you. I love-
It's not what you think. Please.
You're cheating on me! With him?
No, no, Beast. I promise I'm not. I'm helping him, that's all.
I'll bet! I'm sure you help each other just great! I know what this place is! I know what goes up!
Beast, stop this. Right now, this isn't the way to handle things.
What do you know? You don't have anybody! What the fuck is wrong with you? She's my wife!
Beast, listen to me! There's nothing going on! I'm not-
Hey!
Bastard! I guess I finally see you for who you are!
Stop! Stop it!
Is this you staying out of it? I thought I could trust you!
Listen to your wife. Just calm down and-
Beast! What the hell do you think you're doing? You aren't even listening to me!
She's my wife, Bigby!
I told you! Stop! Please! Leave him be! This is my fault!
This? Bigby.
Look what you did to the door! You can't just act like this whenever
Stand
you-
Stand back! You don't want to see this.
Shit.
What is it? Oh my god!
Don't touch anything.
Is this?
Lily met her client here. Mr. Smith, whoever he is.
And then?
Must have happened right here.
Jesus.
Last night?
Yeah.
I was on shift last night.
On shift? Beauty, what?
I'm not a prostitute, you idiot. I work the front desk.
So that's...
Yeah.
Still, this is no place for someone like you. I mean, look.
Do you remember who rented this room last night?
I don't think anyone did. Not last night. Maybe they have it long term. I don't know. How am I supposed to know? It just seemed like a totally normal night. How is that even possible? There's so much blood.
Go lock the front door. Keep people out of the hallway. I need you to be sure no one comes in here. This is a crime scene, okay?
But...
Just do what he says. I'll explain later, okay? Bigby, what kind of a person could do something like this?
That's exactly what I'm about to try to find out.
I can't believe this.
Looks like she was lying down when she was killed. Flowers were already here.
How do you know that?
Blood pattern. Also, I'd say the body was dragged off the foot of the bed. There.
The body. Jesus. You could say she. Poor girl. I just can't even imagine. What is that?
It's a book about Snow White. Or about the Mundy version of her story, anyway.
The whole book is about her?
Yeah.
Why is she in a glass coffin?
This is the part where she's in a deep sleep, but they think she's dead.
What's it mean? Why mark the page where she's sleeping?
I think he made up the bed to match the coffin in the picture. Flowers, too. He'd have had Lily lie down just like this.
You mean just before?
In the story, that's when someone comes to kiss her. That's our Mr. Smith.
This is creepy. The coffin and the weird fixation on Snow. What the hell is wrong with this guy? God.
He brought wine.
Classy.
It's a huff and puff.
I thought you were the only one who smoked that crap brand.
Apparently not.
Bigby, this? I think I heard this music last night. It was playing pretty loudly for a while and then stopped in the middle. I didn't think twice about it at the time. I mean, you hear all kinds of things around here, and I guess I've already gotten used to blocking them out.
Could have covered up the sound of the murder.
Poor girl.
Someone's been rough with this dress. It's torn.
Oh no, she must have been wearing it. He killed her and then he took it back off?
No, there's no blood on it. It must have been torn some other time.
What are you thinking?
It This is the same dress as the one in the book about snow. I think Smith was dressing Lily up in it to recreate the snow from the book.
You're right. It's the same dress. It fits. He's acting out scenes from the book. That poor girl. She couldn't have known. She probably just needed the money. She could have been anyone. How did she wind up here? I mean, not exactly here, but just how does a person...
We can't know the answer to that. Every situation is different.
Yeah. She must have been so scared.
Do all the rooms have these same clocks with the built-in cassette player?
I think so, yes. Maybe she didn't see it coming.
Is there anything else you can tell me about last night? Anything that sticks out in your mind?
Sorry, no, it just seemed like every other night does. That's exactly what's bothering me. From now on, I'll just be down there imagining this.
How can I find out who rented this room?
Find whoever has the key? I'm pretty sure this one must be held long-term. And we don't keep a register or anything. This place is intentionally kind of anonymous.
I keep hearing that.
Damn it, get it together, Beauty. Be strong. Do you smell something?
No. Just apple.
Oh no, there's more? What? What now?
It's got a single bite taken out of it, like in Snow's story.
Oh no, do you think it was poisoned?
It wasn't. I'd have smelled that. I think it's just a prop. It's here because they were acting out the scene in the book.
Of course. That makes perfect sense. He's just acting out another part of the book. God, I can see the whole picture now. It all goes together like you said. This creep put that girl in a Snow White dress and recreated the whole story from the book with the apple and the deep sleep and everything. You're a better detective than I thought you'd be.
Thanks.
So he planned it all out. He had all the details noted down. Only then, when it comes time to kiss her and wake her up...
Yeah.
I hope you're just about through. I don't really want to stay in here any longer. Of the dead girl?
Not all of them.
How do you know?
I'm in this one. It was taken last winter.
Oh no. Bigby. This kind of stalking, it doesn't just stop by itself. Trust me, I know about this firsthand. He'll keep trying to get closer and closer.
His stand-in for Snow is gone now, so...
The next step closer. What is it?
It's Crane.
He could be after you now. Good. I am dying to get my hands on that disgusting weasel.
I'm really starting to like you, Sheriff. You're not afraid to be a complete bastard.
Obviously, there will have to be some changes.
Hello, Bigby.
Take care of it, Bigby, or I'll take care of it for you.
Jesus Christ, Bigby. Is that you?
Thank you.